بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the King, the Master, the Sustainer, the Creator of the seven heavens and the earth, and we send peace and blessings upon His beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, our life in this world is extremely short, far shorter than what you think. Many of us, we've got hopes and plans and dreams and ambitions. And the truth is, let me be very real with you. Death will come to you. Death will meet you way before you can achieve at least half of your ambitions and your dreams. Nobody is promised tomorrow. Nobody. Death will come. It's promised. It comes unannounced. That is the reality. That is the haq. That's the truth. No one knows when his time is. And my brothers and sisters, the very reason that we've been created, the very reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He put us on this earth, is to do what? Why are we here, my brothers? And please, yani, let's just off the bat, whatever I'm going to say, I'm sure there's differences of opinion, I'm sure other people have other, wallahi, I'm good to everyone, wallahi, good luck to everyone. I'm just sharing my views. So my brothers, why are we here? Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create us? Are we here to play games? Be honest. Are we here to play games? Why are we here? Wallahi, my brothers, the more I spend time with the youth, I see that, you know, and we always blame the youth. The truth is that the youth is a reflection of what came before them. Everyone's so focused about the youth, and our youth are lost, and our youth are confused, and our youth, Habibi, our youth are lost and confused because you're lost and confused. Because our fathers and mothers were lost and confused. Very easy to stand and point the finger and say, look at them. Look at them. Habibi, your son, your daughter is a reflection of you. It's a reflection of you. How did you spend your time? What are you doing with your life? Your kid is trying to do the exact same thing, maybe through a different path, but the exact same thing. So why are we here, my brothers? Is the purpose of life to get married? Is the purpose of life to wear nice clothes? Is the purpose of my existence to build a big home? Is that why I'm here? Or am I here to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Am I here? Has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has placed you on this earth for what? For short time. If Allah gives you life, how much is He going to give you? 80 years? 90 years? 100 years? And then what? And then you're going. And then you're going. And then what do you take with you? What do you take? Wallahi, my brothers, this world is so trivial, you have no idea. No idea. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created you for a short time to worship Him, to call to Him, to glorify Him, to establish deen in your life. Two things, my opinion, two things. The purpose of your existence on earth is to establish deen in my life and to establish deen on the earth. Simple. Deen in me and deen in others. That's the purpose of your life. That's why you're here. Wallahi, my brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't care. He doesn't care. Allah doesn't care how much money you have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't care how many cars you drive. Allah doesn't care how, you know, how big your house is, how many bedrooms, whether there's en-suites, you know, granite bench tops, bench. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't care. It's all dunya. Al-dunya mal'una wa mal'unun ma fiha. Law kanat ad-dunya ta'dilu 'inda Allah janaha ba'uda ma saka kafiran minha sharbat ma. The Prophet of Allah, he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this world is so trivial. This world is so pathetic. This world is so cheap in the eyes of Allah. It's so cheap. It's so worthless. He says, if it doesn't, but if this world had any value in the eyes of Allah, Allah would not have had given a single kafir a sip of water to drink. Not a sip of water would He have had given a single kafir. Imagine someone that hates Allah, he hates his prophet, is an enemy of Islam, clear, open enemy. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still gives them, still opens doors upon them. Money, cars, women, palaces, empires, governments. And Allah gives. Why? Because all of it means nothing to Allah. It's worthless. This is not success. And what's sad is you and I, the Muslim, you and I, the ones that have been given deen, the ones that have been given light, the ones that have been given the greatest gift to humanity. The greatest gift is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the Quran and the book of... We've left that. We've left the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We've left his deen. We've left his way. We've left his sunnah. For what? What have we left it for, my brother? What, for this world? For this dunya? For this dunya? Whoever left this world and took anything with him? Whoever left this dunya and took anything with him? Yet we still fall in the same holes. We still make the same mistakes. The night has been cold. Which side are you on? Ask yourself, which side are you on? Are you on Allah's side? Are you on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Are you on his side? Which side are you on? And don't, wallahi, don't fool yourself. Claim, claims, claims, claims. Habibi, everyone talks. If talking was going to allow us to enter into paradise, Habibi, trust me, we're all in Firdaus al-A'la. But you look at the Sahaba and you look at the Prophet, they spoke very little and they did much. Today we speak very much and do very little. Which side are you on? Wallahi, my brothers, every single person is searching for happiness and we're all searching for success. Every human is. Muslim and non-Muslim alike. Everybody wants to be successful. Everybody wants to be happy. Everyone wants to be ahead of the game. But Allah has sent you the Prophet. Allah has sent you His book, His Quran, to show you which path is success, to show you which path leads to happiness. And we've left it and turned to what? What have we turned to? What have we turned to? People ask me, Akhi, why are we suffering? Why are we miserable? Habib, why do you think we're miserable? The Prophet of Allah, he said, I left you on the clear road, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I left you on the clear road. I left you on the clear path. Layluha ka nahariha. It's night. It's like it's day. I left no stone unturned. Look, I ask you by Allah, a man that taught you how to clean yourself in the toilet. Imagine he showed you how to clean. Not just how to clean. What hand to use? What hand to use? You think someone that went through so much detail is going to leave you lost without direction? He showed you exactly a map. He gave you a map. People ask me, Akhi, what do I need deen for? Have you ever heard this? What do I need deen? You know why you need deen? Because deen is your GPS through life. Deen is your GPS through life. If you don't have deen, Habibi, you're a lost soul. You're chasing your whims and your desires. Deen is a GPS. I'm lost, Habibi. I'm lost. I don't know where to go. I don't know what to do. Deen, GPS. Turn around. Final destination where? Jannah. Fine. Your location, final destination, that's the road. Follow. Follow. But nahna, no. The road is clear. It's there. I can see it. Let me... And everyone thinks he's a doctor and a scholar. Habibi, no, trust me. Go left here. I'll show you a shortcut. Turn right here. Trust me, Anna, I've been here before. And then when he turns right, is this it? Wallah, I don't know, man. I don't know. Wallahi, you know, there used to be a tree. I think they cut the tree. The ukhadba, left and right and U-turn. Habibi, what do you waste your time for? The path is there. The path is clear. Wallahi, my brothers and my sisters, please try to understand this concept. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not looking to be impressed with what you can come up with. You know, sometimes people think that, you know what? That look, I know that that's the path, but I want to impress Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I want to do something else, or I want to do something extra. Allah is not impressed with this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not looking for that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear. This is my path. This is my road and this is my prophet. And you will only success if you follow his road. Anything and everything other than his way will lead you to destruction, even if it's under the banner of deen. Yeah, and if I want to create, and this is where this whole topic of bid'ah comes from, if I want to create a new form of worship, It's sincere. It was really for.